Hello, hello, and welcome back to Soviet Republic, Workers and Resources. So we have just connected this to here, and I hope to God that I can sell the bricks here. Whoa, 65, that's 650 per truck. We've got 4 trucks. So that's a substantial amount. That's good, so we're making money out of this as well. Now seems like February is done, so we can actually go in here, look at last month. And we can see how much money we've made, how much coal we've sold. We've sold 255,000 units of coal, which is a good amount. It's a substantial amount. What's happening here? It's pretty low. This carries 360 tons of coal, so that's fine. I think we can make up the 360 tons actually. It was 525. So let's see when this ends its route, how much that is at. And I think there is no harm in following it. It's 525. So the number we are trying to see here is 525. So by the time we deliver it and get back, this has to be 525. If not, we'll have to remove one of the hoppers from this train. Actually, it's going down further. And that, I'm pretty sure, is... What the hell are you? You're a crane. Alright. It takes some time to offload it. So, that is good. I don't think it'll come up to 525. We would effectively like something a little bit more. If it's like 530 or something, it should be good for us. But I don't think it's gonna come up to that number. If it does, I'll be ecstatic. Oh, we got a new train. Might actually make it to 500 something, but the key number we are looking for is 530, which it's not going to do. So it's better to return this to the depot. And get rid of one of the hoppers. And send you on your way again. I think one hopper was not sufficient to get rid of the excess weight. So let's see, it's 490. So when we come back, it should be more than 490. Where the population moves in this game is actually pretty nice. It's pretty fine. I think we should have more games like this. 2 million. Oh my god. 2 million last month. 10 million down already. We imported a lot actually. We've imported almost the exact same amount that we've exported. This is all, right? Yeah, this is all. This is for the last 5 years. Oh my god, I can't believe that we've only been operating for 5 years. For 5 years, we've done a really good job. I mean, we've borrowed money, obviously, but we've kept things afloat. Right, we need to go back to the depot again. Get rid of one more of the hoppers. Because yeah, it's not effective. It's definitely not effective. Like, we are losing more coal out of this. I mean, I know I've done it in such a way that if there's no coal here, it'll just wait here, but what's the point of just waiting there? I guess you could argue that there is a point in it just waiting there. But yeah, I would rather have a little bit of stockpile building up. The stockpile is building up here, which is good. So let's quickly jump down here to our old city. If I can call it the old city. I mean, the oldest city is like 5 years old, so it's not necessarily an old city. This is filling up on fuel, that's good. Well, fuel's not coming out here much. Bitumen's not coming out at all. What the hell is wrong with you guys? You are getting oil. It's just not enough. Are we running out of resources? Can we run out of resources? Production has gone down considerably. There's nobody here. It's like the cities are dying out. Cities are dying out. I think I want to attract more people to these cities. So let's get a small shopping center here. Just to attract some people in. See, this still has people, and the only extra thing this has is the shopping center. Actually, that's not true. It has the football ground as well. So there are a couple of facilities around. So let's hope that this shopping center makes a difference. It's alright, it's not so bad. Are you serious? The cement's all filled up? Really? How is this going? 541, negative 92,000. Positive 300. Okay, this year is 1.583 already. 1.583 times 4. So let's say 1.5 times 4 is going to give us around 6 million. So 6 million just on the top line. which is going to be tremendous actually, because last year was only 4.8 million. So 6 million is a tremendous amount. Where is this showing? Wait, let's see here. Oh, we've paid 88,000 back. We owe 1.929. Penalty interest rate is 8.1%. What the hell is a penalty interest rate? Oh no, there's a building on fire. It's in the old city. That's okay. They can fix it. Oh, there's a coal here as well, which is getting stockpiled like hell. ₹600 per round, and it's still getting stockpiled. Maybe I should increase this coal. This train's, you know, like the number of carriages it has. Has a lot of carriages actually. But should be fine. Let's get two more hoppers on this. Okay, I'm gonna let the game run, because what I'm planning on doing is I'm planning on returning a considerable chunk of the money. We can let it run out. It's not that we can't. It's just that I don't want to. So let's return 1.5 million. So we've returned, we have only 500,000 more to return. Holy shit. I can't? I literally can't. So this train is like maxed out. Should I get two trains then? That would be a nightmare, wouldn't it? This one train per trip is giving us 37,000. Wow, we were. Trains really do look beautiful. Like they're extremely, extremely pretty. Right? Like, I mean, I don't know. It's like, when you think about it, if there was another parallel civilization which grew up, would trains actually be a thing? Because I expect boats would definitely be a thing, because whether, you know, whatever kind of organism they are, when there is a huge mass of liquid, they would like to cross it. So yeah, sure, boats would be a thing. Flights would be a thing, aircraft would be a thing, and road vehicles, and I mean, even if there are no roads, you would have land vehicles which go on the land, so that would be a thing. But would trains be a thing? Trains are where you have specific rails, and the vehicles are actually restricted to the rails. It's something that I think about a lot, you know, and something which fascinates me, because I don't know if they would. It's a very specific kind of invention. So you don't have anything equivalent to trains in most of the other modes of transport. Like, you don't have specific corridors restricted to airplanes. Although I guess all air travel is kind of like that. We have corridors which are restricted to them. Or ships, for example. Ships are pretty much free to go however they want to go. They're not restricted by the rails. So yeah, it's kind of interesting to think about. I don't know. I don't know if it would have happened or not. I expect it would have, but how is the question? How would it have come about? Because the main reason that rails came about was because of mining operations, right? So at least that's the story I heard. So they started mining stuff and they had rails which went in and went out to keep the goods, to keep all the products flowing, all the ore flowing freely from within the mines to outside. And they just built on top of it. But they're just so beautiful, the way they hug the landscape. Especially in India, when I was growing up, rail was one of the most important modes of transport because air travel wasn't as cheap or as efficient as rail was. You had huge distances to travel, right? So you could basically get a train ticket to go for like 3,000 kilometers for next to nothing, literally. It was like 500 rupees at best, like the best coach. Of course, I'm talking about way back when 1 rupee meant much more than what it means right now. But yeah, it was like, it was very, very cost efficient for you to travel by train. It took you 2 days to cross that entire distance, sometimes three. But even then, it was much better than shelling out tens of thousands of rupees to complete that journey in a couple of hours. And flights back then weren't comfortable and they weren't accessible to everybody. Even if you had the money to buy a ticket, you probably couldn't get a reservation because the flights were full. Now you can fly anywhere within India within like 2 hours or 3 hours. 2 hours, 3 hours at the most. Most places just like a short hop, it's like an hour and a half. And it's definitely changed the landscape of the country. It's changed how people look at travel and people look at how integrated the country is. Because back then it was a task. My cousins used to come down from the north for their holidays and it took them 3 days to come down and 3 days to go back up. So it was arduous. You know, they were like, for 6 days they were on the train, they were living on the train basically, which means that you can't come down for the weekend, you can't see your family, your extended family for the weekend. If you have to do it, it has to be well planned. You have to do it for, you know, you have to do it for 15 days or 20 days for that to happen. Right now I don't think about travel in those terms at all. There's no place that I want to go to where I think, oh, the travel time is 3 days. There are places where travel times are 3 days and 4 days, but normally don't go to those places, I guess. Right, so we can possibly return the rest of our cash. 420, 420, nice. So we've returned everything. That's convenient. So 26,000 people actually want to come in from the Soviet side and 26,800 people want to come in from the Western side, but we haven't accepted anybody. So I guess in the next couple of episodes we might actually look at how to do that, how to get tourists coming inside, because I hear that tourism is like very, very lucrative. But we've just paid off all of our loans, so I don't intend to borrow any more money. In fact, next couple of episodes might just be us marveling at the landscape and looking at the trains and whatnot, because, I mean, hey, that's something interesting. So let's look at our population statistics. Average lifespan is 77.89. I don't know if it's become better or not. I think it's become better. It seems like it's become marginally better. Yeah, it's become marginally better. Average productivity is still pretty low. The unemployed workers is going down. Seems like there's enough employment. The average age kind of sloped down and then went back up again, which is good. So there's nobody without education because we are playing on the easy mode, obviously. The basic education, almost everybody's basic educated. University education levels are going up, which is good. Lot more people have computers. Around 10% of our population has computers, which is good. 15%, I won't say 15%, but yeah. Quite a few people have televisions and a lot of people have radios, so the number of people who have radios is going up. Car owners is pretty pathetic. Have a radio, have a television, have a computer. Alright, so that's all three. So this is all the education, and this is the actual population versus the number of people who have cars, which is zero. Okay. Culture, enjoyment. Alright, so let's see this. Happiness is at an all-time high, which is good. Holy moly. We have... Oh, it's actually gone down. That's good. Oh, it's a shame I can't click on it and hover over the graph to see the number. Anyway, the number of deaths spiked a couple of months back. Not a couple of months, almost a year back, but it's become better now. Births are spiking right now, so it seems like we are doing really well. Immigration spiked because we invited people in, but now it's pretty normal. Adults 21 plus still living with their parents is going down. Children 7 to 21 is going up. Babies is, whoa, that's booming. Productive age workers is going up, that's good. Actual population is, it's pretty much following the same graph as the production, so that's good. Alright, so on that note, I'm going to put a quick cut in this video. Do like and subscribe if you like the content that I'm putting outside. Do comment if you think anything is comment worthy, and I'll be back in a quick bit with the next episode. Until then, take care now. Bye bye then.